Well, welcome, guys. Welcome to a new Let's Play. This is, of course, Super Mario Galaxy. Now, this is pretty much the sequel to Super Mario Sunshine and Super Mario 64. It follows the same, you know, same general pattern as those games. Go to different worlds, collect power stars, you know the deal by now. Now, this game I don't actually like as much as Super Mario Sunshine or 64, but it's still a pretty good game. In some aspects, it's a lot easier than the other games, but never mind that. Mario games have never been, like, extremely hard. Alright, so we're gonna start a new file. Yep, we'll make a file on this planet. We'll go ahead and use Mario's face, because why not? Ta-da! New file made. So, let's get this started. Every 100 years, a comet appears in the skies above the Mushroom Kingdom. The comet was so large one year, it filled the skies and sent countless shooting stars raining down. The Toads brought the shooting stars to the castle, where they became a great power star. It should have been a very happy time for the citizens of the Mushroom Kingdom. That was the night of the Star Festival, held once every 100 years to celebrate the comet.
Dear Mario, I'll be waiting for you at the castle on the night of the Star Festival. There's something I'd like to give you from Peach.
Oh, so the princess has something for us. There's our favorite Italian plumber. Right, now these things here are called Star Bits. You can collect them with the Wii Remote. Those will be useful for later. Oh, that's a cool. Oh, he's just carrying a Star Bit. I thought he had a beard for a moment. I'm trying to. Alright, Mario, so off to the castle we go. Oh boy, it's an airship fleet. I wonder who could be behind this. Wow, look at all this destruction. Hello, Super Mario Bros. 3 airship theme. Oh, Bowser, what are you up to this time? Yep, there's the big man himself, Bowser. Got some kind of new power now? Where did he get that? Alright, Mario, let's go hurry up and help the princess. She's gonna need our help. Damn you, Bowser. You're always going too far. I'm coming. Hold on, princess.
Yeah.
Oh, great. They're gonna uproot her castle. Again. You already tried pulling this trick off in Paper Mario, Bowser. Yeah, let's just rip the whole castle off its foundation and take it into space. We're here. Uh-oh. Magic Koopa. Crud. Well, there goes Mario. And Peach is gone now as well. To who knows where. Also, I find it kind of funny that they took away the voice acting since Super Mario Sunshine. I guess him talking had a negative reaction. Oh. Hello there. Where are we? No. Hello, buddy. Wanna play? This is hardly the time to be playing, but okay. Come here. More rabbits. Let's play hide and seek. If you can catch all of us, we'll tell you about where you are. Okay, I guess. Let's see if we can find them. Oh, there's one. Come back here. Gotcha. That's one down. Oh, one of those star things. In the crater. Aha! Come here, you wascally wabbit. There's two. Okay, I guess we'll check out the pipe next. But it is cool how the long jump is back in this game. Because in Super Mario Sunshine, there was no long jump. At least I'm pretty sure there wasn't. I mean, you had the flood and all, so you didn't really need it. I'm gonna get you. Gotcha. Alright, we found all three of you. Help your mama. Sorry about bringing you here so suddenly. We should probably tell you where you are. There's a connection here to deep space, far from your lands. We call it the Gateway to the Starry Sky. Mama's waiting up above. Please help her with whatever she asks. Okay. So I guess this must be their mom. Watching you from here. This place is called the Gateway to the Starry Sky. My name is Rosalina. I watch over and protect the cosmos. To save your special one, you'll need the power to travel through space. Luma can give you this power. I will entrust you with his care. Ah, so they're called Lumas. Wahoo! You have the ability to spin now. Just shake the Wii remote. Disaster has struck us, just as it has visited you. With Luma, I hope you can rescue the grand stars. May the stars shine down on you. Now, Rosalina has apparently become, like, really popular with Nintendo fans recently. She's, like, in everything. I know she's an unlockable character in a Super Mario 3D World. Shake to spin things that look breakable. You can even spin enemies to stun them. Okay. This is a launch star. Shake the Wii remote when you're near one to shoot through space like a comet. Now go and explore the universe. There are lots and lots of galaxies for you to discover. Oops. Alright, and away we go! Meteor smashed up a launch star. You can't leave without it, so find all the star chips to fix it, and be sure not to fall in the black hole. Gee, thanks. Ah, Goomba. We'll squish the Goomba. So yeah, on planets like this, you definitely have to be careful not to fall off, or you'll be sucked into a black hole. I don't want that to happen. We got an additional Mario. Couldn't just call it a one-up. There we go. Launch star activated. Or fixed in this case, I guess. Now, just like in Sunshine in Super Mario 64, coins restore your health in this game. Get me out of here. One of those enemies should have the key. Okay. Let's kill the Goombas. Ow. There's the key! Compared to Super Mario 64 and Super Mario Sunshine, though, In those games, you have, like, 8 health bars. In this, you only have 3. You can double it if you find certain mushrooms, but other than that, you only usually have 3. Sure, we'll go rescue your buddy. Whoa! That is a giant Goomba! Now it's a dead giant Goomba. Also, these star bit things we're collecting, you can fire them using the B button on the Wii remote to stun enemies, but it's more useful to collect them. Because eventually we need to be feeding these star bits to hungry Lumas, and they'll get us to secret areas and stuff. So for the time being, let's try to collect as many of the star bits as possible. Oh, have you now? That's a grand star. We have to save it. They're using the grand star to power that awful machine. It looks like it's making something. We have to do something before the grand star's power is drained. Quick, find a way to stop that machine. You got it. So in order to stop the machine, we're gonna have to hit all of these floor pads and floor buttons in here. Yeah! Make them all blue. Oh, they're called flip switches. Fair enough. I'm working on it. Ta-da! Machine deactivated. That really wasn't much of a defense system, though. Well, we all know Bowser isn't really known for his intelligence, but whatever. You've got a grand star! Or, you got a grand star. Ooh, check this place out. Hey, there we go. Looks like that grand star restored some power to this place. Some of it, anyway. Ooh, and we've discovered a new galaxy. The beacon is lit again. It shines weakly, maybe only as bright as a classic star, but at least the poor Lumas will survive now. Ah, so they are your family. Welcome to the Comet Observatory. It's my home and also home to the Lumas. You see, we travel to starry skies. We pass by this area once every 100 years, but we suddenly stopped in front of this planet. A strange force had latched onto our ship, pulling away star bits and our power source, Power Stars. Our ship had lost power, so it entered a deep hibernation state in which it could not move. Those who took your special one picked up the Power Stars and discovered the power to cross the universe.
Please.
Please, I have a request. This observatory uses star power to project images of the galaxies that are scattered across space. There is a chance we can use our few remaining stars to look for other power stars.
Look.
These round rooms are called domes. We observe galaxies from those such as these. But the only one that is working now, powered by the star power you restored, is this one, the Terrace. Please go to the Terrace and try to recover the stars from the galaxies you can see from there.
Look.
If we do that, we'll be able to restore the Comet Observatory's ability to fly like a starship. Then, perhaps, we can pursue the thieves who ran off of the Power Stars. Well, I don't think we really have much choice.
Look.
Alright, let's get to it then. So this is essentially the main hub of this game. This is where you'll go to the different worlds and to the different galaxies. Right now, there's only one place open to us, and it's this place here, the Terrace. Here we go. This dome acts as an eye of the observatory. From here, we can gaze upon distant galaxies. Alright, so he's gonna turn into a pole star. Let's grab it. These are the galaxies that can be observed from this dome. The numbers represent their distance from the observatory. The bigger the number, the greater the distance. The more stars you find, the farther you will be able to travel. So right now, since we only have one star, this is the only one we can unlock. The Good Egg Galaxy. Alright, we'll be careful. Let's fly to Good Egg Galaxy. Dino Piranha. Sounds mean. Alright then, welcome to the galaxy. So we're still going to try and collect as many of the star bits as possible. It will help us out in the end. If you spin against enemies and defeat them that way, you're more likely to get star bits. But if you just squish them like that, then they'll usually just drop coins. That's what I've been doing. I'm collecting star bits. Ooh, lots of star bits there. I thought there was a warp pipe around here. Let's see where it leads. Now those gold things that are attached to the wall there, if you shoot a star bit at them, they'll produce a coin. Just kind of cool if you ever need one in a pinch. Oop, let's follow the notes. Oop, I missed one. Kind of screwed it up there, but it was indeed the underground theme, from Super Mario Brothers. If you get I don't want to quit yet. All right, so let's keep going. Yeah, for every 50 star bits you collect, you get an extra one up. Same with coins, I think. And off we go. Coins really aren't as important in this game, though, except for restoring your health. Yes, we knew that. Alright, we're gonna have to collect the launch star chip so that we can fix the launch star. Try not to get crushed to death by the boulders. Alright, where's that last one? There it is. Now we can fly off. Those are weird things. Kind of reminds me of those things that would absorb water from you in Super Mario Sunshine. Oh, grew a vine. Squish. I just need to spin the Wii remote on that thing. Get out of here. Right, there's a black hole on this planet, so we'll have to be careful not to get knocked off. Big piranha plant. Come here, you. And goodbye. Hello there. lots of star bits from you. You can also pick them up by just running into them, but it's much easier to just point with the Wii remote. Yeah, so we can't just spin infinitely. Looks like we woke it up. Now we need to hit its tail. And boom! Say hello to Dino Piranha, folks. We just need to get behind it and keep hitting its tail. Yeah, why not? And goodbye, Dino Piranha. So there's our first Power Star. Not counting the Grand Star we got at the start. You got a star.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
To Lumos, they are the tastiest, most delectable treats imaginable, those star bits. Aim at a screen and point your pointer at them to pick them up. Once you have some, shoot them by aiming with the pointer and pressing B. Yes, I explained this not too long ago. Alright, I guess we can do that. There you go. You can also shoot them at enemies or feed them to a hungry Luma. Either way, I'm sure Starbits will be a big help on your adventure. Alright, so let's go collect us some more Power Stars. A snack of cosmic proportions.